General symptoms of fungal diseases. So today we will see what are all the different types of symptoms which is produced by fungi. So my name is N.H. Shankar Reddy and I am doing a PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. The first one is rust. So red to orange or brown color rust pustules appears on the leaves and stems. On the right side we can see. So red color or orange color or sometimes brown color pustules appears on mainly on stem, and few of the cases we can also observe on leaves. The best example is wheat stem rust, which is caused by Puccinia graminis tritici. If we understand the life cycle of wheat stem rust, it will be very easy to understand the entire pathology, almost 50 to 60% of the entire pathology. Second one is smut. Here the infected parts, especially seeds, are converted into black color powdery masses. The infected portions on the right side and the maize grains we can observe, the infected portions are converted into, entire infected portions are converted into black color powdery masses. If we touch that, the powdery spores we can observe on the infected portions. So example, corn smut, which is caused by Stylobomedes. Next one is mildews. Here mildews of fungal diseases are two types, that is powdery mildews and downy mildews. Here on powdery mildews, the name itself indicates white color powdery growth appears on leaves, as well as we can also observe on fruits. Here the most diagnostic and prominent symptom of grapes powdery mildew is cracking symptoms on fruits that we can observe on powdery mildew. So on the right side we can see the diagram. Cracking symptoms on fruits is the most prominent and diagnostic symptoms of powdery mildew of grapes. So grapes powdery mildew is caused by Erysipelae nicator. It is the new name. The old name of Erysipelae nicator is Uncinella nicator. The next symptom is grapes downy mildew. Here the most prominent and diagnostic symptom of downy mildew is mummification of fruits. The fruits are mummified in grapes downy mildew. So here grapes downy mildew is caused by Plasmopara viticola. That disease is the main reason and responsible for the development of Boromycher by Milodot. On the right side we can see the diagnostic symptoms of mummification of fruits. That is the diagnostic symptoms are at grapes downy mildew. Next one is root rots. Here mainly the disintegration of root regions that we can observe when we pull off the roots. So if the roots will disintegrate, what will happen? The plant roots will can't able to get the nutrients from the soil. Due to that, what will happen? Those the fleshy leaves, tubers and fruits, all those things will start to disintegrate. Here the name itself indicates root rots. So rottening of roots. So example is dry root rot, which is caused by Macrofomina fasciolina. So all the root rots which is caused by Macrofomina fasciolina only, that may be a sunflower root rot or maize root rot, whatever the root rot it is, that is caused by Macrofomina fasciolina. The next one is blights. So blights, here the name indicates blightening, which means a death of leaves, floral organs, stems and branches we can observe. Due to this rapid generalization of browning, what will happen? It can't able to do the photosynthesis, then it starts to death, it starts to die. Initially starts from leaves, then it extends to floral organs as well as stems and branches. Best example is botrytis blight, which is caused by botrytis species. So the next one is the leaf spots. The name indicates spots on leaves. So in my technical terms, so how can we say that? Bull's eye-like appearance that we can observe on leaves. On the right side, we can see initially black color or brown color spots appears on the leaves. Not only this leaf, but also on each and every leaves. Whatever the leaf spot is, initially it starts with a black or brown color discoloration. Later slowly extends, or you know, later it like look like to bull eye like appearance. That's why they mentioned the particular term, that is a bull eye like appearance. So the best example is Alternaria leaf spot. Alternaria leaf spot, which is caused by Alternaria solani. Don't worry about this, all those fungal names and all those things. When we get into this classification, it will be very easy to understand what I'm trying to go with. So the next one is wilting. So what is wilting? Wilting itself like desiccation or loss of water, that is simply wilting. So what will happen here? Due to wilting, the loss of turgidity is the most prominent and characteristic symptoms of Wilt's. What will happen due to Wilt's, which is present, I mean, like xylem vessels or phloem vessels, which is there in the stem, what will happen? It can't able to absorb the water. So due to this, what will happen? The plant starts to drying and desiccate. So due to that, the plant look like almost look like to wilting like symptoms. So later on, it may dies. So which is caused by, best example, chili fusarium wilt, which is caused by Fusarium solanum. The next one is cankers. Here, sunkening of woody tissues can be observed here. On the right side, we can see here almost the tissue got dried off, and whereas the bark also starts to remove slowly. Here the canker is generally caused by bacteria and fungi also. So here now we are discussing about fungi, so we can see diseases related to canker, diseases related to fungi. So the example is apple European canker, which is caused by Nectaria galligena. The next one is anthracnose. The most prominent and diagnostic symptom is ulcer like lesions we can observe on the right side. We can see on mango, ulcer like lesion observed on fruits, ulcer like lesion observed on leaves, ulcer like lesion observed on stem also. Here what we have to mainly consider ulcer like lesions on fruits, because it is the productive or effect, main part for marketing and as well as, so we can consider it mainly. So the ulcer like lesion that we can observe on fruits, flowers and stems of the host. Here mango anthracnose, example is mango anthracnose, which is caused by Colletotrichum gliosporoides. Damping off. Here damping off, rapid collapse and death of young seedlings. So young seedlings will die rapidly before the emergence. So here the damping off is of two types, that is pre-emergence damping off and post-emergence damping off. Here this type of damping off that we can mainly observe on nurseries, because seedlings are playing the major role in vegetable nurseries. So what is pre-emergence damping off? Coming to the pre-emergence damping off, the seeds will rot before they emerge from the soil. So this is the pre-emergence damping off. The seeds are rotted before the emergence from the soil, that is pre-emergence damping off. The second one is post-emergence damping off, which means the seeds will die after the emergence. So these are the two types of damping off, that is pre-emergence and post-emergence. This is the diagrammatic representation of pre-emergence damping off, then this is a post-emergence damping off. We can see that dying of seedlings here and here. So here the damping off is caused by pathogen, that is a Pythium aphanidermatum. The next one is scab. So here scab mainly can observed on leaves as well as fruits. Leaves and fruits, what will happen in this scab? Localized lesions can be observed on fruits and tubers also, and plant parts also, especially like leaves and fruits. So what we are considering here, because of economic parts are we are considering much, because economic parts are the marketing part, so we can mainly consider on fruits. We can see here localized lesions that can observe later on. The localized lesions extends, so they can almost look like a very hard surfaces. Due to that, what will happen? The nutrients which is present in the fruits get absorbed, and but this is one of other reason for this disease is calcium deficiency. So in apple, due to the calcium deficiency, what will happen? I'm not telling the scab is mainly due to calcium deficiency. What I'm trying to tell you is, due to calcium deficiency also, the fruits will rotten like this, and the bitter taste will be we can taste that. When we taste this, bitter taste will be can be observed. So the main best example for apple scab is Venturia inequalis. One is a very important one. The next one is dieback. So dying of a plant parts, that may be leaves. The right side, we can see no plant part can be alive here. You can see the leaves, no leaves will be there. Even the bark will look like less strengthy, and almost look like a die. It look like almost have no strength. And you can see here also. So the progressive death of shoots as well as twigs also. So death of shoots and the twigs of infected plants. Due to that, almost all plant look like vanished in later days. So it is caused by dieback of apple. Example is dieback of apple, Monilinia. So dieback is also caused by bacterial pathogen. pathogens. So here are galls. So what will happen in galls or tumors? The plant pods get enlarged, especially in root region. We can observe here. You can see here, so small galls. An enlargement of plant pods may be observed. That is galls. What will happen in galls? The enlargement of plant pods. Plant pods get abnormally enlarged. The main reason for galls is due to the production of, hypertrophy and hyperplasia. So due to the production of gibberellins and some other hormones, what will happen? The plant pods will develop abnormally. So due to this, what will happen? There is a formation of galls and as well as tumors. So the multiplication and enlargement of plant cells is mainly due to hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Hypertrophy means abnormal enlargement of cells, that is hypertrophy. Hyperplasia means increase in number of cells or cell divisions, that is hyperplasia. The best example is club root of cabbage, which is caused by pathogen Plasmodiophorobrassicae. We'll see the next. Leaf curls. So here the name indicates the curling of leaves. The leaves are curled, that may be upwards or downward, whatever. The leaves are curled, thickened and distorted. We can see here the leaves are curled. For simple, the curling of leaves, that is leaf curls. So it is example is peach leaf curl. So the peach leaf curl is caused by Taphrina deformans. These are all the general symptoms and a few of the important general symptoms which is produced by fungal pathogens.